is Axel Barr and today we're talking to a couple of mine safety specialists.
Christo de Klerk, it is good to have you here. I appreciate that very much. You are in charge of mines rescue in South Africa since 1982. Altogether, you are overlooking 123 mines of all different minerals. With your experience and expertise, you are acknowledged and respected worldwide. Maybe you can tell me a little bit about your motivation that you have for this challenging task.
Axel, I grew up in a mining house, in a mining town. You know, my father worked in the mines, my brothers worked in the mines. Together we have got over 70 years of mining experience just in our family. And growing up in a house, knowing that your father's going underground, you would like to know that if anything happens to him, that someone will be going down underground to go and rescue him. And that's always been my motto in South Africa, is that if you go underground and anything's going to happen to you, you must know that someone will come and rescue or save you. And that's what's driving me, is that passion. It's a passion, absolutely a passion-driven work to rescue people, to recover people if need be, and then also to save the property of all our member mines. So it's absolutely, passion is in my blood, and that keep on driving me to always do a better job for the South African mining industry.
And now if we look a little bit into the future, and as it becomes more and more challenging to access world's resources and the mines are getting deeper and deeper, then what impact does that have on mines rescue?
Yes, we can clearly see it in South Africa. We've got some older mines that's very deep. We've got the deepest mines in the world. We are currently mining at 4 kilometers underground, and we're busy preparing to mine now at 5 kilometers. And we now find that some of our conventional rescue methods do not suffice anymore. And that's why in my presentation I just did, we are now developing new rescue winders so that we can actually perform rescues at this excessive depth. But then also, the deeper we go, the hotter the environment becomes. So we have to cater in our rescue capabilities, we now have to cater for the heat, the long distances that we have to travel, that has got a major impact on our rescue strategies. And then also, the deeper they go, the more mechanized the mining becomes, and therefore the smaller the excavations. So we have to re-look at all of our rescue strategies and our rescue equipment to continue with effective rescue operations in the future, especially in these deep mines.
But do you see any limits, and what could that be?
I don't think that the depth will be a limit. I think that, you know, in today's technology, we can mine deeper. The limit will be that there's other ore bodies that's easier accessible. But in South Africa, if that is the only ore bodies left, I am sure we will develop ways and we will continue to remove the ore even if it is at that depth, yes.
Refuge, and we heard that today, refuge rooms and or chambers give miners a safe haven in case of emergency. What are your experiences with refuge rooms or movable shelters, and what is their part in your rescue concept?
If you look at mining in South Africa, it is extensive, labor intensive. We are making use of a lot of people because the majority of our mining is conventional. And the people that we use in our mines, they are coming from our neighboring countries, somewhat totally unskilled people. So you cannot train them in sophisticated equipment so that they can do a self-escape or a self-rescue. You have to give most of our people a device which is very easy to don and to operate. And then we must ensure that they can get as quickly as possible to a safe shelter where they can stay and wait to be rescued. With our mines that is so deep and the long traveling distances, it is impossible for any person to walk out and to rescue yourself. The distances is just too excessive. So from my experience in South Africa, and we've used it numerous times, we've rescued many people from refuge base. So a refuge base is absolutely essential. Without that, a lot of people would have died. We've had a lot of fires recently. In one of our recent fires, 5 people lost their lives. We actually found their bodies very close to a refuge chamber, so they were on their way there. So refuge chambers, there's definitely a place for it, but there's also a rescue chain, if you want to call it. There's 4 very important components in this rescue chain. And the one is the belt-worn self-rescue, it must be of very good quality. Training, I think people do not give enough emphasis to training. Training is very important. The thirdly is the travel conditions, the traveling way or the route that the people have to travel, which is not taken into consideration sufficiently. And the fourth one, is, of course, is the life sustainability of the refuge chamber, which is extremely important.
Okay, you mentioned one of the threats. Fires underground are always the biggest threat for miners and the mine itself. Who should first respond? What kind of equipment should they wear, and what kind of training is necessary?
Yes, I think prevention is, of course, the best if you can prevent fires from happening. But in South Africa, we train every underground worker the basics in firefighting. That is taking a fire extinguisher and trying to extinguish a fire. Our vehicles, they are equipped with automatic fire suppression systems. But it's more important that that worker must know his limits. And if he cannot contain the fire immediately, he must evacuate. Otherwise, he's going to place his own life in danger. So it's very important that you must teach people, they must try and contain the fire. If not, move out. They must not try and become heroes, because then they will endanger their own lives. So there's definitely a first defense that can be done by the normal mine worker, but they've got limitations. And they must know their limitations, and when Mines Rescue must come in and take over the situation.
Now, we heard a couple of these presentations today, and you are attending, obviously, the 6th International Mines Rescue Conference here in Niagara Falls. What is your impression after day one, and what do you take home with you to your organization?
You know, it was established in Poland, this International Mines Rescue Body, and I believe it is so important. Mines Rescue in every country is relatively small, and you cannot exist all by yourself. And you cannot do R&D all by yourself. So instead of reinventing the wheel in every country, you come to this conference, you come and share ideas, you listen what's happening in the world, you can see what is the newest technology. So I believe it is so important to have this conference. It's exchange of ideas, and it can only ensure the safety of mine workers all over the world. So I really believe it's one of the best forums, and I hope it will continue for a very long time.
Thanks for your time, Christo, and the answers.
Thank you very much.